Hi, today we've come to a place that's almost 1,000 years old, somewhere that a lot of Americans will have never seen one of. But in the UK, there are loads. I'm coming to one of the old ones, one of the oldest ones that there is in the country, that started off made out of wood and is now in stone. We've come to Pontefract Castle. Let's go have a look around it.
Pontefract is situated in West Yorkshire, right in the middle of the country, if you like. And the castle itself is situated right in the middle of Pontefract. Now, I would suggest going to Fairwood Car Park. It's quite near the actual castle itself, as there's no actual parking at the castle. As we walk through those gates, just look at those formidable walls. One of the best things about this castle is it's free to enter. The castle has stood witness to centuries of drama, intrigue, and conflict. As we walk through into here, you can't help but wonder the stories these walls hold. If they could only whisper the tales of the powerful nobles, deposed kings, and fierce battles. Let's find out a bit more about it. The castle actually began life in 1070, just after the Norman conquest of England. And it was a person called Ilbert de Lacy, which I've probably pronounced wrong, who came along and built a big wooden structure, which was the start of the castle itself. This was soon replaced by stone and produced the structure that we see today. In front of you there is a plaque which would have been the coat of arms of one of the lords that ruled the castle at one point in its history. Obviously very, very weathered now. But also, those two long structures on the floor, they're knight coffins. The big round thing that we're looking at is just a vault. Victorian water filter, a bit bigger than the water filters we get now with your water in the fridge, but there you go. And then next to it, a Roman coffin. Just shows this area had people staying on it an awful long time before the castle as well. The castle itself was actually referred to regularly as the Key of the North. Anybody who's watched Game of Thrones may recognise the terminology a little bit. May not be exactly the same, but this is where it originated from. Because it was known as the strongest hold in England. It was a crucial holding for the powerful de Lacy family, and later passed through the hands of other prominent figures. But perhaps the most famous resident of Pontefract Castle is in fact a tragic one, King Richard II. In 1400, King Richard II was overthrown by his cousin, Henry IV. Deposed and imprisoned here in Pontefract, his story takes a dark turn. The exact circumstances surrounding his death later that year remain a mystery. Some believe he was assassinated, as depicted in Shakespeare's play Richard II, but there's no real proof. The unresolved question adds to the castle's aura of intrigue, because he was certainly executed here in some manner. Fast forward a few centuries and the English Civil War takes place, and Pontefract Castle, once again, finds itself right in the centre of the conflict. This time it became the Royalist stronghold, fiercely resisting the parliamentarian forces. Show us it. Point to it. No, go on down so you can see you. What is it, Thomas?
A tulip.
Yeah. Now, legend has it, during one particularly brutal stage of the war, the parliamentarian soldier managed to infiltrate the castle itself, hiding himself in a cartload of hay. Once inside, he opened the gates, allowing the comrades to swarm in and take control. Now, whether that story is true or not, it highlights the ingenuity and the desperation employed during those times of war. The scars of multiple sieges are still visible on the castle walls, a testament to its resilience. Here's a fairly unusual little thing in the castle grounds. If you stand there and the sun's shining, it will tell you the time. Yes, it's a sundial. There is a local legend worth mentioning. Some whispers tell of a black monk ghost said to haunt the area. While many of the accounts place the haunting near the house at 30 East Drive, which if you want I'll do a more in-depth video about, there are reports of this monk coming from the castle itself, where it's seen walking up, particularly near the kitchen ruins itself, to the Queen's Tower. Of course, we have no concrete evidence to support these claims, but they add a touch of mystery to this fantastic place. And here we are at the kitchens, and you'll notice that some of the bricks are red, and that's from where they used to cook, from the fires that would, over time, change the colour of the bricks themselves, the stonework itself. And to give you an idea of these stoneworks, in this example, a modern day version of it, here's our son hiding in it. So you can see they were big, but not that big. And in Civil War, they were actually converted to make musket balls and to repair armour. Now, there were dungeons in this castle, and you can visit them. One of the things that you can actually do is, if you go into the shop, they will actually give you a ticket to go and go on a guided tour. Unfortunately, the dungeons weren't open at that time, but the guided tours were there for others. We just missed them at the particular time we were there. This area that we're coming to now is actually the storage area where they would keep food, etc., for them to actually use in the castle itself. And you can see it's just basically a flat area that would be caved off, but it's existed right up until now. But the key factor about this place was the thickness of the walls. They protected it from bombardment, from any of the heavy-duty weaponry that the opposition would have. The first main siege of Pontefract Castle began on Christmas Day in 1644, but it was 3 weeks before the castle was subjected to its first serious attack. On the 17th of January 1645, a parliamentary guns batteries began to an intense bombardment of the castle. They had directed it to the western curtain wall. The bombardment lasted for 5 days. During the time, Drake recorded 1,367 shots against the castle. It failed. Between the 22nd of January and the 12th of February, there were only 33 shots against the castle. On the 24th of January, Drake recorded the following statement in his diary. They came to be partners with Guido Fawkes. You may know him better as Guy Fawkes. To dive downward to the devil, to undermine us and blow us up with several mines. But we perceived their intentions. We answered them with their own weapons and mined as fast as they. Shrinkage in several places within the castle and mining from thence. In other words, they were dug in from outside to try and blow up the castle underneath the wall itself. But instead of getting all the way through, the royalists who were in charge of the castle up the other way and put mines underneath them and blew them up. We're now at the central tower of the castle. Imagine the climb up there. It wasn't exactly easy, it was walking up, even with the steps. But wow, the view. You could have seen anybody coming from miles away. There is absolutely no way somebody could sneak up on the castle itself. You can imagine sentries stand there watching out over the land. You'd see anybody coming. Yeah, there's a few places barred off from us to actually get to, but they'd be stood out there and able to see anything coming towards them. No wonder they called this the Key of the North. It was unstoppable. And all that land there was for people to come into the castle for protection. The castle was the defence, and people would live outside. Then they would come in the event of any dangers to the area. A massive area where you can imagine a lot of people would actually stay to be protected. And you'd have meats, you'd have fish, bread, cake. You wouldn't have necessarily drank water though. Well, not much anyway. You'd have had beer, because the beer was better for you than the water. Water tend to have things growing in it, whereas beer, well, it was cleaner for you. The first siege that the royalists beat them at, took them a month of starving them. And there would be the whole village around it at that time, staying in here. Quite a fantastic sight. When you look down at the size of this place, all those people could be stayed in here and fully protected. This is the keep, and you may recognise it because it looks very similar to something at Clifford's Tower in York. This was supposed to be the place you went in the event of a siege, because it was the strongest part of the castle. You can imagine that at the end of a siege, going in there, feeling that little bit safe, like you'd have a safe room in modern day expensive houses. This was their equivalent. But it obviously didn't always work when people had already got into the castle itself.
Well, I really hope you enjoyed our little trip to Pontefract Castle. Fantastic place, free to visit, and right in the middle of a busy town. And it's almost 1,000 years old. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and that little button there. The next video. See you on that. Bye for now.